All right, Double Boy, Shipper Rice is coming for you.
Now, this is an all NA affair. Now what you have to see them do here is agree to the mirror match, and it's got to be a fun mirror match. I want to see, like, Lee Sin Vane versus Lee Sin Vane.
Oh, that would be awesome. That would be so exciting. Well, look, here's the bracket on your screen. We've got now got the final four duos competing. The return of Captain Jack and Faker will be taking on QTV and Zeros. Captain Faker, this is a duo. They're playing for solidarity for the LGBT human rights in Korea. It's providing safe spaces for the LGBTQ youth in South Korea. And of course, if you win, make it to the finals, 100 grand towards that charity of your choice.
And 25K just for qualifying for the finals, even if you lose. So, you know, more than doubling that charity of their cause would be very nice. And these guys are one win away from the finals.
Exactly. And their opponents, QTZ, which is, of course, QTV and Zeros, they're playing for Reach. This is a charity that's giving support or opportunities towards the impoverished youth in Vietnam. Regardless of whether you make finals or not, there's a minimum of 10 grand going to those charities. Mm-hmm. So it's a very substantial amount. I think total is $265,000 going towards charities from this 2v2 pro-am. But now we're in the semifinals. Now it's Captain Faker taking on QTZ. Zale, these guys have had two games to play already. How do they adjust a pick and ban strategy?
Before we get in, I have a more important question for
you. Oh, okay.
Have we been missing the opportunity for just calling them cuties?
We have. This is the right time.
I'm actually kind of disappointed in ourselves. How did it take us three matches to realize that their team name is actually just cuties?
Because we are incredibly serious.
Oh. And
we definitely came in here a little bit too try-hard. Maybe. I don't know.
I'm disappointed.
All right. Well, look.
That's all I have to say.
There's only three matches left up. We're sitting on the side of Korea versus Vietnam on this side of the bracket. NA versus NA. And then for all the marbles, for all the bragging rights, Captain Faker versus the cuties.
Yeah. Captain Faker versus the cuties. I mean, you gotta be looking cute, feeling cute to play your best.
Right. So I'm gonna ask a question, but there is a caveat.
Okay.
The most fun 2v2s we've seen so far has been Shipper Rice.
Yep.
I want to make that is established. So
they're
outside of them. What have you enjoyed seeing and what would you like to see more of now in the semis and the finals?
I think Captain Faker's first one was really, really fun.
What did they play?
It was the All-Star game. The
yes, All-Star Lucian Alistar.
I just think the all-in stuff is more exciting because you know that if you're losing on farm, you have to play for a kill, right? Yeah. So it's kind of building to that crescendo. It's not a question of if they're going to do it, it's when they're going to do it.
Okay, I like that.
I think that's kind of more fun. Whereas the teams that are playing purely for poke, well, you can just play farm and just kind of sit back.
So in that same style, the Annie Brand, for example, in that same vein, right? Like you have to look for an engage. Age at some point.
Exactly. I mean, think about, the Malphite game we had earlier in the 2v2 on the first day as well. It's like they have to go for the dive. They've got to find the kill. Those are the most fun games for me.
Okay, now put on your predicting hat for me.
Predicting
right?
hat. Okay.
Captain Faker have played two different styles. They did that Lucian Alistar that you talked about. And in the previous game, they did Varus and Xerath. Mm-hmm. You have to feel now you're in semi-final, you're getting close to finals. Surely the seriousness goes up.
Yeah, I mean, it already felt like from the first round to the second, the troll went out the window a little bit because, Faker was known for anytime he got in solo queue with Captain Jack, he would ask to role swap to support.
Yeah.
Captain Jack didn't want him supporting him. He'd pick Alistar, right? So it's all, trolling his teammate there. But then I was hoping he was just going to play Alistar with him the whole way through.
I was hoping the same thing.
But, Varus plus Xerath seems like very heavy poke, very smart sort of play style. But they've had some close matches, to be fair. They could have got knocked out in either round.
Okay, so let's see. Poke probably then is the expectation.
Yeah.
It's sort of the safer option. You can still go for the kills, victory. But again, I'm going to overread this. Look at Faker. Very nervous. He's biting his thumbnail.
He's never played in such a high-pressure match.
Never, never. Semi-final 2v2 pro-am. Faker's never been there. Like,
never.
This is a fact.
Never before.
But look how slow the bans are coming through. A lot of strategy being imposed. Serious faces. QTV's photo, he's smiling, but on camera, he's stressed.
That's true. He is stressed out. They're probably scrolling right now through the champs like, so, who do we ban?
Yeah, exactly.
Sindra, sure. That sounds good. Okay, let's do it.
Well, they followed up with Varus. One last option. I mean, Brand is still up. Nico's off the table.
The Casio bans. Boy. Defining the meta.
There we go.
2v2.
North America defining the meta.
Really, okay. That's the classic. Sometimes it's for the good. Sometimes for the not so good. You have NA Casio, but you also have NA Jace.
That's it.
You got to take the good with the bad, Quick Shot.
And NA Snowballs. It's about sending a message, I learned today. Quote me on this, ladies and gentlemen. Back-to-back international semifinals for the North American LCS. Yep. They might make a final as well. Yeah, they will make a final because it's two of them.
They might. We might find a way
to
lose that.
Oh, my word. Okay.
I've been more disappointed before. Who knows? They could both get disqualified and Europe somehow gets in there to find a replacement.
All right, I'll get League Ops on the line when we're in game, see if we can find out a loophole. But it's going to be another pivot. Captain Jack and Faker are going to play something a bit different. Ezreal and Urgot. QTV and Zeros, the cuties, they've got themselves a possibility to go for this like poke all in. But Ezreal Urgot, again, I see the combo. You poke down with the Ezreal. Mm-hmm. We've seen Urgot's tankiness early and then just land the kill once you get the disdain.
Yeah, I mean, Maple, it looked like, you know, it was working pretty well for him. And then it was that failed dive where they actually got a 1v2'd. I believe that was actually, you know, it was against the cuties. So
there we go.
They did lose that there. But, you know, Captain Jack and Faker perhaps watching that and think, hey, we could do that a little bit better. I mean, definitely do agree. The all-in, even just from the Ezreal ultimate now, that is not reduced damage passing through those minions. So you can actually have a pretty powerful follow-up. If Urgot can flip them in, you hit him with the Ezreal ult and a Q. Well, that's probably got them in alt range again.
Yeah, absolutely the case. And we turn our attention to the other team. The shield from Orianna is going to be helping a lot. This is actually our first Orianna in the 2v2s.
We saw a lot of 1v1s.
So many 1v1s. Yeah. But her whole kit, like the magic damage on her passive, you've got zone control with the wall, you've got a shield, you've got a movement speed on her W. So the kit just really works in this format of the game.
Yeah, it definitely does. I also think one of the kind of undervalued things is that you don't have wards on this map, so actually being able to check the brushes with the ball is also pretty decent, having a little bit of vision control there if like people want to try to play that brush. So we'll see what the strategy is going to be. If Faker is going to go for more of a poke style Ezreal, if he's going to go for more sustain, you know, there are some options here. It is airy. Okay.
All right, let's see what they do. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2v2 Pro-Am semifinals. All the bragging rights and that charitable donation is on the line. Quick reminder, you get win by getting 100 CS, 2 kills or the tower. And right now it's Korea taking on Vietnam. LCK versus the VCS. Advantage, Captain Jack and Korea with a mystic shot to the face of Zeros.
Yeah, nice start there for them. And you know, you can see Faker is playing Aftershock, which, you know, really does kind of lend itself to that all-in. You hit the flip, you get that Aftershock. That, plus your W shield is actually very, very powerful. It makes you pretty tanky. And, you know, they should have a really strong all-in, especially if Captain Jack is hitting a lot of these Qs, as he has been so far.
Well, Captain Jack and Faker already got themselves a couple of mystic shots. Decent start to this game. The Biscuits, again, we've seen them so frequently again. It just fits everything that you want. From this map.
I mean, it's guaranteed sustain, right?
Yeah.
And it's also, you know, if you're getting poked out, hey, that pops up. Maybe you don't have to base at a bad time. Maybe you're not going to fall behind in the farm. So certainly I think it is the best secondary. The only kind of caveat to that is maybe if you're playing against something like the Darius Leona, the only way they win is with a full 100-0 all-in because they have no poke.
Yeah.
So then maybe resolve secondary makes more sense, but it's mostly been poke versus poke where Biscuits reign supreme.
Well, a lot of credit here to Captain Jack. I really feel like he's putting a hurting on those mystic shots. QTV and Zeros, you play a little bit more behind that minion wave if they can. Obviously, when you have minions right now, there's nothing to work with. And again, Zeros just gets chunked down, so gonna start burning through those consumables already. And this is a good start. The Seer doesn't find Faker. Pillar of Flame does. That's very good reply from QTV. And look at how low Korea have gone down.
Yeah, I mean, Captain Jack got hit by a few of those dissonances and command attacks from the Orianna ball. So despite the fact that he's been pretty on point with his mystic shots, you know, he's the one who's actually lower on health. Now, they did get a potion out of Zeros, but Faker trying to juke out a lot of these spells.
Oh, going very aggressively forward. Faker down to 150. Summoner heal's been used. Flash away. Burning is ticking. Zeros stays alive. The mystic shot misses its target.
Still up.
There goes the flash engage. That's a chase down from Zeros. Zeros 100 HP and they back. So 1-2 summoner spells blown by Faker. The same for Zeros.
Yeah, Zeros is down, but we see both Captain Jack's summoners are available. So it's 3 used compared to the 2. They are going to start popping up these potions. The all-in could be pretty scary. Again, you have to remember, Zeros is going to be flashless. If he ever gets caught, certainly won't have much of a way to escape here.
No, definitely not. The QTs from Vietnam, they're down in CS, 6 at the moment. If they pick up most of this, they've still got their entire minion wave that'll push towards Korea. So you're talking sort of an 8-ish advantage with CS on the map. And Captain Jack and Faker will be happy. I mean, they still, they've got the kill potential if they want to play for six. And then they can farm from range with Mystic Shot, which will help them out.
Yeah, definitely can. You know, it's pretty nice allowing Faker to go back to base. And maybe now Captain Jack, now that Faker is back, may decide to make his own return to base. But a biscuit popped up, right? So he's going to be able to stick around a little bit longer. And we'll see how well they do picking up all this farm. But as you said, certainly should have a pretty decent advantage if they're able to do it.
And I'm starting to see some more picks as well that you just start thinking about how you last hit under the tower. You know, it is slightly different rates on the summoners, the ARAM map. But Shocker Knees, very useful. Mystic Shot Damage Jam, very useful. Just helps you guarantee those last hits when, you know, CS is a win condition in this mode.
Yeah, totally. It is a pretty big deal. And also, I mean, CSing from range is obviously that much easier. We'll see, you know, how they're going to be able to do it. You know, the Vietnamese team, definitely they are behind the VCS squad, but that being said, their all-in is also very powerful. Faker does not have an ultimate. If you can get a full brand combo into a shockwave, that is pretty terrifying too, so we'll see.
Ooh, really good damage onto Faker. You can see the full combo. He's down to 200.
Base.
Needs to back. This is really, really good. The VCS, they're still down 10 CS with the wave.
Oh, the damage.
Them. Good damage from Captain Jack, landing absolutely everything on this newly updated Ezreal. We are playing at 8:24, ladies and gentlemen. Captain Jack continues to chase. That's another Mystic Shot, applying tons of pressure to QTV and Zeros.
Yeah, that was really well played, actually, by Captain Jack. I mean, the brand W, the Pillar of Flame thrown behind him, so he just actually arcane shifts forward towards the brand and just gets that damage in, even knowing that he had already dodged out from most of that skill shot damage.
Yeah, the Pillar of Flame, going to be pushing that wave forward ever so slightly. And now Captain Jack can just shoot fish in a barrel. Sit all the way back, use those Mystic Shots, and just really, really be annoying to QTV and Zeros. And Korea just playing with the lead again. They've been very controlled in both of their previous 2v2s.
Yeah, they really have. You know, playing it out pretty intelligently. No potions remaining on this VCS squad, so the LCK team certainly going to be looking to keep them round if they can. Captain Jack could actually set up a freeze if they want, but looks like the option is going to be the push. And they're just kind of playing this interesting game where, I don't know if they're going to go for the freeze now with the cannon.
Yeah.
But since it is kind of like the offset cannon wave, sometimes it does mess it up. They should have it regardless. But you know, Faker and Captain Jack are essentially just taking turns farming and then basing. Like, Faker comes out, you know, he tries to poke, he takes some damage, he goes back, Ezreal farms, then Faker gets back, Ezreal goes back to base, and they're just kind of rotating through where the VCS team is doing more of these kind of synced bases, and they end up missing more CS as a result.
Well, let's talk about the buys. QTV and Zeros, they've come back with boots, potions, they got double Doran's rings. There's no boots on the side of Captain Jack and Faker. So if Captain Faker are a little overextended, the additional boots and the additional all-in as we get to six could be the difference maker.
Definitely could. I mean, if you could dodge out a skill shot, if Faker can't close the gap, you know, that's a really big deal.
Yeah.
Faker is now six. Both Brandon and Orianna are sitting at six, so we're kind of just waiting for Captain Jack here. And then if they can find it, we could see them go. And Faker trying to close the gap.
Oh, stepping forward, that Pillar of Flame. Again, the threat, if you step into it, the follow-up, now that Pyroclasm is available and the Shockwave. And look at Captain Jack and Faker. They're respecting the Q. Respecting that command attack, 63 CS to 53. It's still Korea in control, so it's up to Vietnam to make a play. A big wave to push, but if they want to win and have that advantage, they need to push back on the CS, Azale.
Yeah, Captain Jack not able to hit with the ultimate there, but you can see the VCS team is trying to... Oh, nicely done by Captain Jack, caught by the shockwave, though.
Shockwave comes back, Pyroclasm starts to bounce, the Fear Beyond Death is flashed away from it, Faker doesn't care, lands a disdain, Zeros goes down with zero HP. Now QTV is trying to get the kill, the burst of the bomb, not enough to kill Faker yet. Flash is already used, continues to chase. QTV needs to land the skill shots, and Korea, they've escaped for now. Seer is available for QTV, but he will not find an opportune target. Flash, disdain, the shield, QTV's down. Captain Faker advanced to the finals.
So well done there. Faker still had the flash. He finds the brand, but that was close to being another 1v2 turnaround from this VCS squad. They were able to do it against the LMS players earlier, but not quite able to pull it off here against Captain Faker, who were just looking so clean. Really well-coordinated duo there.
Well, North America are going to start getting nervous. Captain Jack with the best celebrations here at All.
I just want to see FLICKR do that with him.
Yeah.
That would be fantastic. But here it was one more time. The ult bounce is not quite enough to actually take down Captain Jack, and then FLICKR, you know, soaking up so much damage with the aftershock. Captain Jack comes back in, and it's here that you're thinking, well, maybe Brand can actually just kill them both. I mean, FLICKR, though, squeezes out with almost no health, waits for his cooldowns, come back up, gets the flash E, knocks him back up. Captain Jack on point with the skill shots. Yeah. They pick up the second kill. That was just very well done. And yeah, even the VCS team giving him a round of applause. Well deserved.